21 seconds, and the solid rocket booster engine gimbal now underway. T-minus 15 seconds. T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. We have main engine start. 4, 3, 2, 1, and liftoff. Liftoff of the 25th Space Shuttle mission, and it has cleared the tower.
Roger, roll, Challenger. Good roll program confirmed. Challenger now heading downrange. Engines beginning throttling down now at 94%. Normal throttles for most of the flight, 104%. We'll throttle down to 65% shortly. Engines at 65%, three engines running normally, three good fuel cells, three good APUs. Velocity, 2,257 feet per second. Altitude, 4.3 nautical miles. Downrange distance, 3 nautical miles.
So the 25th Space Shuttle mission is now on the way after more delays than NASA cares to count. This morning, it looked as though they were not going to be able to get off.
1 minute, 15 seconds. Velocity, 2,900 feet per second. Altitude, 9 nautical miles. Downrange distance, 7 nautical miles.
Looks like a couple of the solid rocket boosters blew away from the side of the shuttle in an explosion.
Welcome. After about 40 minutes of searching, I finally found it. I am in Concord, New Hampshire, at the Blossom Hill Cemetery, visiting the grave of Christa McAuliffe. This is a beautiful, beautiful cemetery. It is huge. We had to go and ask somebody for help on where to find her grave because it's just so ginormous. Where we were looking was way off in the distance. Through pictures online, we were looking for landmarks like benches and trees. Still couldn't find it, so we had to ask somebody for help. And Christa's pretty famous, so, you know, a lot of people knew exactly where she was. And sure enough, we got to the right spot. If you don't know who Christa McAuliffe is, she was aboard the Space Shuttle Challenger that exploded and killing everybody on board in 1986. And right in front of me right now is her grave. Let's take a look.
So this is the grave of Christa McAuliffe, and this is what her headstone says. She was a wife, mother, teacher, pioneer woman, crew member, Space Shuttle Challenger, America's first ordinary citizen to venture toward space. She helped people, she laughed, she loved and is loved. She appreciated the world's natural beauty. She was curious and sought to learn who we are and what the universe is about. She relied on her own judgment and moral courage to do right. She cared about the suffering of her fellow man. She tried to protect our spaceship, Earth. She taught her children to do the same. And if you can see down at the bottom, you can see all the little things that her followers
look at
have
this
left
one.
And look at a little kid made a clay rocket ship, and that's just so heartwarming to see.
There's a pin there, some cobwebs. I'll clean that up. Make sure I don't get bit.
I think next time we come here, maybe get some flowers or something.
Definitely.
And all the rocks.
Look how beautiful that is. Somebody made this for her. That's
all the
awesome.
Rocks that are left on top.
All the rocks.
An American flag right on the side.
This reminds me of Scott.
Yeah.
Scott on tape.
Yeah, definitely. It's just a sad situation all around.
So Christa McAuliffe was born Sharon Christa Corrigan. She was born on September 2nd, 1948 in Boston, Massachusetts. She died January 28th, 1986, which is when the shuttle took off from Cape Canaveral in Florida. She was serving as a payload specialist on board. She had two kids, Caroline and Scott. Caroline was 9 years old and Scott was 6 years old. She received her bachelor's degree in education in 1970 and got her master's degree from Bowie State University in 1978. She was a social studies teacher at the Concord High School in 1983. And she won an award, I believe it was some kind of a contest that was going on. And in 1985, she was selected from about 11,000 applicants to the NASA Teacher in Space Project, is what it was called. And she had won. And she just really wanted to go up in space and talk to students while up in space giving lessons. I mean, that's just something so beautiful. You know, I don't know if they still do things like that today. She's not the first civilian up in space. There was another woman who went up in space, and another guy. He was the first African-American to go up in space. And I believe she was the third civilian to go up in space. And it's just, it's amazing. It's a tragedy, and it just hits you, you know, right in your heart. Somebody so local that just wanted to do good. And I believe that the space shuttle had an O-ring that failed. It was snowing and it was really cold out the day before, and they were supposed to take off January 25th, but they waited a few days and they ended up taking off on January 28th. There was a rain and ice storm, like I said, the day before, and it caused the gaskets and the O-rings to fail because they get really stiff. And I believe in the footage you can see black smoke pillowing out of like what they said was like a credit card size slit. And I don't know, maybe the engine compartment or something. And they don't even think that the crew that was on board passed away instantly. They believe that they died on impact, which is terrible, which means they have about 2 minutes of free falling to figure out what they're gonna do. And not only that, they had to wait an hour and a half before they can even go out and recover or do a rescue, because there was so much debris falling from the sky. I think it was like an hour and a half worth of debris falling from the sky. I mean, that's just insane. So when they got to the shuttle, it was in the water and the oxygen masks were deployed, and they could tell that a few of the buttons were pressed. A lot of people do believe that they did die during the explosion, but a lot also agree that they died on impact because of the buttons and the oxygen mask deploy. If you can see that car behind me, I was just speaking to that amazing woman, and she was watching the rocket take off. I say rocket, but it's a space shuttle. She was watching it take off live. And she told me that her two kids were there watching it. And the whole school was there watching it, her class, and saw it happen live. What a tragedy. I mean, somebody you know and is doing this courageous thing that nobody really gets to experience, you know? And they just, you know, words can't describe how those children felt, how her kids felt. It's just crazy. Just so you get some sort of scale reference, her grave is over here this way. Look how big this cemetery is. There is even more down that way. That's where we drove in from. So beautiful. If you ever have a chance to come to New Hampshire, I highly recommend it. It's definitely worth the visit.
What really sticks out to me is what says she relied on her own judgment and moral courage to do right. And I really think we as individuals can learn a lot from that statement. We all have accountability, and we all need to do the world a service and just do what's right. And I think her courage in doing what she did leaves a mark for all mankind.
And she taught her children to do the same. This day and age, you know, things aren't the same as they were in the 80s when she passed.
No.
And it's just, it's a terrible situation, but we can learn from this. We can learn from her own words. She seemed like a very nice lady. I would love to have met her. Imagine her being your teacher. My teacher went to space. How's yours? What'd yours do?
Thank you for your service to this country. You are not forgotten.
Hopefully that'll stay. Like I said, Christa had two kids. Her daughter, Caroline, became a school teacher in her honor. That's amazing. Her son, Scott, became a marine biologist. And her husband ended up remarrying, and he became a judge. So here's her grave. I mean, what a story to tell. We're not always going to be doing cemetery visits, but since we're in this area and we live close by, we figured we'd come here and share it with you. Why not? Not everybody gets to go out and visit graves and hear these amazing stories of these people that have passed on. We're going to be doing more horror things, horror related. But once in a while, we'll do something like this. And I mean, it just shows how incredible this world is with all the stories and great things.
Thank you.
That being said, thank you for joining us on episode 2 for the Horror Roadside Show. Remember to high five that like button and subscribe for more episodes and content coming soon.
Thank you.